I want to talk to you about the differences between flipping a single family home versus flipping a mobile home. Hi, my name is Jorge. I have almost 20 years experience in flipping single family houses. But lately, for the last 8 years, my wife and I have been flipping mostly mobile homes. Would you like to know why people like us with so much experience flipping houses, now we are doing mobile homes? That's what we're here today. And I want to give you three reasons, okay? Number one is gonna be the inventory. We're gonna be talking about the closings. And at the end, I'm gonna talk to you about the profit. Wait until then, you're gonna be surprised. Again, as I said, those are the three reasons I'm gonna give you. But I'm not trying to convince anybody to switch to mobile homes. But for some of you, the next few minutes, it might represent the differences between making six figures or making seven figures. I hope those numbers get your attention, because what I'm about to share with you, it is something very impressive. It's really, really good. So let's start with number one, the inventory. Now, when I said the inventory, let's start with the single family houses. I know there's a lot of properties out there for sale. And yes, I understand also that you can find good, but good deals. I'm not arguing about that. But at the same time, there's a lot of competition, a lot of competition. For instance, I remember my wife and I, we are school oriented, so we always taking courses here and there, and they all pay off. So we took this course in Dallas, Texas. The course was about to find single family houses with enough equity and at a good price for us to flip. So we went to Dallas and took the course, and the course came together with a software capable of finding this property within the MLS system and putting it in a format, you know, a sheet, you know, all together, so we can make offers of it. Very good, very good. So we bought it. I mean, we bought it. And let me tell you, the guy who sold us the software was not a fake. We tested the program with excellent results. The software worked perfectly. We went back home, and immediately we started implementing it, and we were very excited. We were very excited. So we started making these offers to all the houses that we got from the MLS. With all of them had enough equity. So we placed all these offers. The problem was that we were not the only ones submitting an offer. You understand me? 8 out of 10 times, we used to get this beautiful response from the listing agent saying, hey, please, this is a multiple offer situation. Submit your highest and best offer by this date. How many of you have gone through that before? We kept trying for a while, and it took us probably, I would say, give and take, 2 months before we find a really good year. We submitted the offer and the offer was accepted. I'm not trying to minimize the courses. There are very good courses out there and they all pay off. We are people who like to do business, okay? And we kept trying. We have tried everything, you know, from foreclosed properties. We even get a list of pre-foreclosure properties. Of course, everything comes with a price. But still, the competition is real. It's real. And let's not talk about the price of the properties nowadays. With the interest rates so low, the price of homes increase. And that makes it even harder to find good deals. For those of you who are looking to flip a house nowadays, you very well understand what I am talking about. Now, let me stop for a second and let me talk to you about a business for those who are business oriented. my wife and I are business oriented, because at the end of the day, if you're a flipper, if you're a rehabber, what you have is another job. Let's be honest, it's another job. I quit my job years ago, and we started, you know, my wife and I, we started doing flippings. And one day we find out that we had a job. We were working for ourselves. So that's when we started thinking about other avenues, like building a business, building a business. And in order to get inventory to expand our business or make it grow, I knew it was going. I was going to need a lot of money if we decided to stay with the build, the site build houses, single family properties. So this is when we discovered about flipping mobile homes. Acquiring mobile homes, buying mobile homes is less expensive. In other words, I could get more mobile homes with less money compared to single family properties. Now, I know what you might be thinking about it. The profit is bigger here. Yes, yes. Well, not necessarily. Wait until we talk to until I talk to you about the profit, you will be amazed. I know that. So going back to the inventory, there was not enough inventory for us to scale up our business, not the way we wanted. Because again, trying to get so many properties not only need a lot of money, but you have to fight for them. There's a lot of competition out there. Now, when it comes to mobile homes, when we find a good deal in mobile homes, most of the time, our offer is the only offer on the table. And the beauty of this is that the seller who is in a rush to sell the unit is willing to negotiate the price. Yeah, that's the beauty of mobile homes. I don't have too many people, like in real estate, bidding for the same property at the same time. And there is a lot of inventory, especially for rehabbers. So you're a rehabber, I mean, you know, mobile homes, they need a lot of rehabbing. So there's a lot of inventory. Let me stop for a second before I go any further. Let me make this disclosure. Things that you are going to hear from me today, especially when I talk about mobile homes, it might sound easy for you. But they are not. It is just in the excitement of the presentation, and since I love doing mobile homes, that's because, you know, the way we talk about mobile homes, we do it from our heart, and it might sound easy, but it's not. In reality, it's not. You know that everything that's worth in life, it takes time. There's dedication and a lot of effort. Knowing that when you are starting a business, you need guidance. That is the reason why we are offering 8 weeks coaching sessions together with this course that we have created online that will teach you all the in and exit strategies. We're talking about rehabbing now. I mean, we can teach you from wholesaling, owner financing, naming all the strategies. We can teach you in that course everything about the market cycle, how to maximize the profit. My wife and I, it took us a few years actually to tweak all these different strategies, because we're used to this. We come from a real estate background, and we were using so many different strategies. And in a mobile home, we'll find a way to tweak them to in a way that we can maximize our profit. Everything is in this course. If you want to know more about it, just go to mobilehomefasttrack.com and get started. mobilehomefasttrack.com. Let's continue with this. I said three reasons. Reason number two, the closings. And I'm gonna talk to you about how all the steps that you need to close a property, okay? So I write it down here. There are 10 different steps. It could be more, but more or less. These are the more known steps in order for you to close a single family home. For those who have ever done it before, those rehabbers, you understand. The very first thing that you need to know that you have to have nowadays is the money. So you gotta find a lender. What is a regular, loan that you're going through, or if you get a hard money lender, you need to have that access. So you got to find a lender. Number two, the realtors. Most of the properties nowadays, and you find good deals with real estate companies. So you got to find a realtor to help you out. Number three, the properties. The properties. So looking for properties usually will take it, of course, depends what is that you're looking for. It might take you less than a month or up to 2 to 3 months. It depends. Number four, the offer. You got to find somebody, of course, you got the realtor that's going to help you out to get the right documentation, like addendums and disclosures. But you have to submit an offer. Hopefully, yours is going to be the only one at the table and it's going to be accepted. Okay. But then again, you got to remember, you got to show proof of funds or approval letter from the lender. That's what we say, step number one. But all these steps, they go along with buying or purchasing, acquiring a single family home. Step number five, title company. Your offer got accepted, and now you got to seek for a good title company to help you out, you know, with title search and put together everything for the closing date. Step number six, the inspections. You got to rush to find a good inspector to help you out, you know, inspect the property, because you only have pretty much 10 days, so whatever time you negotiate for the purchase of the property. But you got to find an inspector. Number seven, the appraisal. The lender usually will send out the appraisal to check out the property. The property worth that much, okay? Now, when it comes to appraisal, I would say hoping that the inspection and the appraisal are okay, now you can proceed. Otherwise, you have to renegotiate the price. It's all part of the deal. Number eight is the loan approval. Hopefully, you got everything, all the documentation that the lender needs, so you're gonna be okay. If you're going through a hard money lender, the usual loan takes 30 to 45 days, but with a hard money lender, it will be a lot less time. Number nine is the property insurance. You might need a property insurance as well. And finally, you come to the closing day. The title company is gonna schedule you. You're gonna come to sign papers. Then the title company is gonna take a few days to process everything, and they will issue you a free and clear title. That's pretty much the process when you're buying a single family homes. Now, what about a mobile home? How long, how much, how is it that this happened? Well, let me tell you this. When we put an offer in a mobile home, we don't need a middleman to help us out. We don't need a realtor. In fact, real estate license is not good to buy and sell mobile homes. In most of the states, you need a special license to do that. But anyway, with mobile homes, I can submit the offer myself directly with the owner. Myself, I don't need a middleman. And since I'm an experienced rehabber, all I need is about 15 minutes, give and take, to inspect the property. That's all I need. And if my offer gets accepted or rejected, either way, but if it gets accepted, I can close this property within one day. That's it. Inspection is done. I don't need an appraisal. I don't need a title company. Actually, I grab the titles and I can go to the DMV or the courthouse and switch titles to my name that same day. Everything is done. Done deal. Of course, there's the community involved, mobile home park community. They might take, you know, few extra days, but nothing compared to the time that you take when you're buying a single family homes, not even close. See, my wife and I have this time, this 1 year actually, that we put together this course online. And if you want to know more about buying and selling mobile homes, everything you need to know about it is there in the course. So go to mobilehomefasttrack.com and get started. Get started. Did I say three reasons I was going to be talking about? Yes, this one. I bet you've been waiting for this one. The profit. The profit. How much can you profit from making a flip on a single family home versus how much you can make versus flipping a mobile home? I know for most of you, you got this behind your mind saying, it's nothing but a trailer trash with $1,000 on it and not gonna make any profit. Well, let me surprise you. Let me explain let me put it this way. How much your money worth when you are investing in something? That is a very good question that you should ask yourself. How much is it that every penny or every dollar that I spend when I'm investing in something, how much that is gonna produce back to me, my revenue? So I did went to school in New York. I went to college, I studied construction engineering. I love numbers, but I think I'm not as good as I wish I would in numbers. So when it comes to formulas, I like to use easy and straightforward formulas to avoid any mistakes. So I'm gonna show you this formula, but I bet that many of you might know about it. The ROI formula. Let me see, I think I brought it. Oh yeah, I put it here. Okay, there we go. The ROI formula is very simple. We use this formula, especially when we're rehabbing properties. We have used it for years because it will give us the efficiency or the profitability. That's a really hard word for me. Profitability of my investment. Again, we have used it very efficiently in rehabbing properties. For those who rehab properties, better get used to this one, okay? Let's see how much worth your money investing in single families. And then we're gonna switch to mobile homes. Now, before I go any further, let me tell you this. To put things in perspective, a good ROI is between 15 to 25% in real estate. It's a good ROI. If your money can produce between 15 to 25% back, your investment in real estate is very good. It's normal. It's right there on the average. No worries, okay? So let's put an example. Let's put an example. Let's use a property, a single family home, and let's use these numbers, okay? Nowadays, if you can find a property for $300,000, okay, it's average. You can find it. The after repair value is going to be $300. So when you finish all your job, you're going to sell it for $300,000. Got me? Okay. But since you are a rehabber, you have to find this property with enough equity so you can do your job and profit from it. So say you find this property with $70,000 equity. So you get it at 270. No. Let me see. Yes, I'm not doing it. 330. $330,000. So you managed to get this property at $230,000. With the software that we have, I know we can find it, but then again, you might find this problem trying to get, you know, in front of everybody with so many offers nowadays for this property. For a property like this, with $70,000 in equity, you gotta fight for it. But say you find it, great. And you can find it, I'm not arguing about it. Remember, we're rehabbers, so we know how to find it. There are quite a few out there. Now the purchase. If you don't have $200,000 to $300,000 in your pocket, you're gonna need a lender. If you're a rehabber, let me tell you this. Let me give you a good tip. My wife and I became members of this investment club in Boca Raton, Florida, years ago, where they taught us how to invest in single family homes, actually. If you're not a member of your local investment club, I suggest that if you want to keep flipping properties, I suggest you to do. Okay, so that's a tip on the side. So they actually provide the funds for you to close the deals. And a hard money lender nowadays, I would say they lend to 80% loan to value. Some give you a better deal, some are gonna give you a worse deal. But 80% loan to value. So the loan is gonna be $172,500. Okay. Don't you think that I'm doing these numbers in my mind? Because I told you I might not be as good as I wish I would. I already haven't written down here. So your loan amount is gonna be $172,500. Okay. Now the closing costs, I will say between the 20% plus, you know, paying extras, about $15,000. Okay. Follow me on this one. Remember, you have a rehab cost. Oh, did I have closing cost? No, actually your closing cost is $72,500 because you gotta come up with the 20%. Okay, so $72,500 is gonna be your closing cost. This is the money you have to bring to the table to close on this property. The rehab cost, by the time you deal with the kitchen cabinets, you bring in new appliances, you fix up the bathrooms, usually the flooring's gotta be new if you wanna sell at that price, remember? Paint, in and out, curb appeal, I mean, say about 15 grand, okay? It's right there. So say you spend 15 grand in rehabbing this property, okay? And I'm not considering carrying costs or anything like that. That's extra. I'm trying to be very conservative in this case, okay? So follow me on this. Your net profit in a case like this, with all the numbers done, forget it. You have another closing. By the time you sell it, hopefully you're not gonna pay the 6% commission to a realtor, only the 3%, which is close to 9,000. Anyway, say 10,000, just to be on the conservative side. Just to be conservative, okay? I'm trying to help this so you can make more profit. Your net profit, if you do all these numbers, you're gonna make $30,000 of profit. If everything goes, you know, the way it is, okay? Now, keep in mind, remember what I said at the beginning? A good ROI is between 15 to 25% in real estate, right? In this scenario, when you put all these numbers into the formula, the ROI formula, okay? The ROI formula, one of the reasons that I use it is because it's so simple. It's nothing but the net profit, it's right here, net profit over your total investment times 100. Simple. It's a simple division and a multiplication. And you're gonna get a percentage number. That's gonna give you how much your money worth actually. So if you're investing in a property like this one, when you put all these numbers together, 30 over, if you add up all the costs, all, everything that you have to put, you know, in order to make the deal happen, it's about $97,500, okay? So you're gonna come out, oh, this is times 100, make it. So the number you're gonna get is about 30%, 30.7% it's a percentage number, okay? It's 30%. That's your ROI. So what that means, what that number means is that for every dollar that you invested in this deal, you're gonna get back your dollar plus 30 cents more. 30% means that for every dollar that you put in, you're gonna get 30 cents more in revenue, okay? So if 15 to 25% is good in real estate, you're doing good. This is a good deal. 30.7% return in your investment is not that bad. It's not that bad, okay? Now, let me see how we can do with the mobile home. Let me try to get these numbers. Same things, okay? But now we're gonna flip a mobile home. And I hope you like this. I hope you enjoy it. Say we find a mobile home that after repair value is gonna cost $55,000. $55,000. I know some of you might not seen them because you probably only know one mobile home park around the corner from where you live. But in our course online, we teach you how to find these properties. There are a lot of really, really good mobile home parks, class A and B mobile home parks, even gated communities, they all over the place. And we can teach you that in our course. So don't forget to go to mobilehomefasttrack.com so you can get started. Mobilehomefasttrack.com. I always have problems with this English. Anyway, mobile homes. The after repair value is $55,000. And the way we do it, we teach you all this in our course. We can find this property. So I'm gonna give you realistic numbers because we do this all the time, all day long. We can find this property for $29,000, okay? The loan amount on this one is zero. I don't have a loan for the $29,000. If I don't have it, if I don't get it out of my pocket, because it's so low, I can't get it out of my pocket. But worst case scenario, I just use one of my credit cards. One or two credit cards, whatever, and put together this number. It's not a big number, honestly. The closing cost in a mobile home like this one, the way we deal with them, we find it in a way that we don't have to use so much. Closing costs we're talking about. Closing costs. Taxes, if you have to pay taxes, but we also teach you how to avoid taxes in this, in our course. I would say $3,500. $3,500. Now, the rehab costs I was talking about. The rehab costs, we find this property in a way that they don't need much rehab, okay? And again, we can teach you that in our course online. Say $2,000 or rehab. $2,000 is a mobile home. You can do it. The second closing cost, because when we resell it, I don't have any second closing cost. All the profit is for me. I don't have to pay a title company because we market ourselves our own properties, okay? But again, this is not taking in consideration the carrying costs or things like that, but that's on the side. But just for the sake of the argument, this is pretty much, you know, the numbers, and the net profit in something like this is going to be $20,500. That's what we pretty much net in a property like this. Now, when it comes to the formula, remember net income over the cost of the investment or your net profit over the total investment. Either way, it's the same thing, times 100. So the numbers are gonna be like this. The total investment on this one is 34.5, and your net profit was 2,500 times 100. When you do the math, which is, again, it's a very simple math, you won't get lost on this one, you will come up with 59%. 59%. Now, do the comparison, because we are comparing apples to apples here. Do the comparison. For every single dollar that you spend in the single family home scenario, you were making $0.34. In the mobile home, for every single dollar that you spend, you're gonna make 59 cents. So your money worth more doing mobile homes. If you can see, the ROI in mobile home is greater than anything else that we have experienced in real estate. That's what we're sticking with mobile homes right now. Now, I know. Some of you might be still thinking about, oops, I made 30,000 here and I made 20,000 here. So this number is bigger. Yes, it is. But keep in mind, don't forget this. Remember that we talk about the closing steps. By the time that you are finishing with the inspections on the single family, you already finished with your first deal in the mobile homes, because it usually takes you one day to buy. By the time you finish with the closing on a single property and single family property, you're already going to the second, probably the third deal on mobile homes. There's more inventory, it's easy to acquire, less money, less risk. I mean, you got everything. So I just hope, again, that I can, that I have been able to give you good advice. Don't forget, my wife and I, we have put together this course that will teach you everything you need to know, strategies, market cycle, and also, let me add this up. The course comes together with eight weeks of coaching. My wife and I are going to be coaching you for 8 weeks. And when I say my wife, I don't know. I think she knows better than me about mobile homes. Once you get to know her, she's the sweetest lady with a lot of experience. And she's a truly businesswoman. Okay, so she and me are going to be teaching you, coaching you for 8 weeks. And that comes together with the course itself. So, something else before I finish this. The course is a business oriented. Definitely it is. You don't want to get stuck in flipping properties yourself. You want to create a business around it. Get the right team, people with knowledge, and do all the stuff necessary, all the steps necessary to create a business that runs along without much of your help. You don't want to get burned out. I've been there, done that. I don't want to go to that those days. So it's a complete course. There's nothing like this on the market. I can tell you that. In mobile homes, it's not even close to that. So if you want to get started, go to mobilehomefasttrack.com. mobilehomefasttrack.com and get started. See you next time. Let me see. Okay. Studios. Okay, where did I go here? I can just close here, right? Let's see, events manager. Okay, let me see. All right, hope to see you next time, guys. Let me end the stream. Bye-bye.